Namaste to all of you. I want to start by thanking Dr. Rangareddy Burri, President IFCOI and other organizers of IFCOI and PHSE Expo for giving me the opportunity for presenting my case study on the life and work for the past 34 years. I reinforced my attention with health consciousness to keep both the physical and mental bodies of the fellow citizens in society hale and healthy by helping them to overcome from non-communicable diseases, NCDs, like obesity, diabetes, hypertension, back pain, knee pains, sinusitis, asthma, sleep apnea, snoring, thyroid, spondylitis, migraine, bronchitis, rheumatism, and brain-related problems like depression, Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, schizophrenia, dementia through multiple therapy techniques of yoga and meditation, and advising them to adopt the lifestyle yoga way and taking food as medicine. Introduction. I am Yogacharya Dr. Somasev Reddy Kodapolu, born in a middle class family in Undavalli village, Tadepalli Mandal, Guntur district, Andhra Pradesh. My basic education service. I studied diploma in civil engineering and joined in state government service of Andhra Pradesh in 1958. I served the department for 39 years with meritorious service and retired as deputy executive in June 1997 and settled at Hyderabad. My health problems during service and after. As my job involved with investigation and execution of civil engineering works, with outdoor activities, I suffered with many major health setbacks during and after service. By acquiring yoga knowledge with multiple therapy techniques of yoga and meditation and practicing yoga as a way of life and swallowing it as lifestyle medicine, I have gained fast and accelerated recovery in all the cases all the time. Establishment of yoga and meditation center. I have established a yoga center named after Swami Vivekananda and registered it under Societies Act, wide registration number 1049/2002, and running it on voluntary basis and with service nature at the yoga halls provided by MPCR Charitable Trust. Next, the yoga center is running uninterruptedly for the past 20 years with a student strength of 150 practitioners daily in 4 batches. Yoga Therapy Center is run concurrently in the Yoga Kendram office in the first week of every month for checking various parameters of the body. Many yoga sadhaks are relieved of their health problems and became yoga teachers out of their gratitude and doing service to the yoga center. The yoga center has been computerized and ID cards are issued to yoga sadhaks every month, and every month progressive data of their health on various parameters issued to them. On an average, a reduction of 2 kg in weight and 2% BMI is observed in every regular practicing yoga sadhak. Vipassana meditation branch was also established and classes are going on regularly. About 5,000 practitioners in the society have benefited through yoga in our center. Health highlights of health setbacks suffered and fast recovery made and came back to normal health. I was diagnosed to have ischemic heart disease during February 1987. I was diagnosed to have knee pains during December 1992. I suffered with lower back pain during yoga practices from 1999 to 2001. Inspired by the preachings of the enlightened soul and spiritual master Swami Vivekananda, I gained fast and accelerated recovery with firm belief, strong willpower, and with continuous practice, adopting multiple therapy techniques of yoga. To have proficiency in yoga and to keep the yoga center as a research-oriented center, I have qualified in yoga starting from diploma to doctorate degree level, commencing from 2001, and obtained 2 PhDs. I met with major auto rickshaw road accident during May 2013. My prostate gland was affected with cancer during December 2015. On 27th January 2016, major surgery with open radical prostatectomy was done at Preeti Urology and Kidney Hospital, Hyderabad. The cancer-affected prostate gland was removed. Two urine bags were inserted for passing my urine outside the body. Surgery took for 10 hours. I was diagnosed to have rectovesical fistula. Emergency diversion colostomy surgery was done. Colostomy bag was inserted outside the body for passing stools. Thus, I carried two urine bags and one motion bag outside the body for 5 months, maintaining hygienic conditions and without attracting the infectious diseases. My major surgery was done at GKNM Hospital, Coimbatore on 9th June 2016. Surgery took place for about 7 hours. On 3rd December 2016, operation for colostomy reversal and fistula repair and bladder neck reconstruction was done at GKNM Hospital, Coimbatore. The two urine bags and motion bag was removed. I was discharged from hospital on 8th November 2016. Thereafter, I practiced in all the activities of Yoga Kendram from January 2017. With all the insults encountered by me, both physically and mentally, I made accelerated and fast recovery. All the time, with strong willpower and blessings of Swami Vivekananda, and by practicing yoga and meditation with breathing and yoga therapy techniques. The two doctors who conducted major surgeries have in their medical certificates expressed their appreciation about the fast and accelerated recovery made by me and shared their views in the international urologists conferences and by keeping my name in the list of challenging rare cases. I was further diagnosed by Dr. V.S. Reddy, consultant orthopedic surgeon and professor and head of the Department of Ortho and Traumatology, Usmania General Hospital on 8th July 1999 as having pain in the knee pains, fine cliffs in the knees. The doctor's certificate is below. And armed with acquired knowledge in yoga, I solved all my knee pains problems without any knee surgeries by the end of March 2005. Dr. V.S. Reddy, the same consultant orthopedic surgeon, during his subsequent examination of my knees on 1st April 2005, found that the knees are moving with full range. The surgeon further informed me, saying that there was no need for medication and advised me to continue the same lifestyle as I am following. These are my yoga practices photos. After writing final examinations of MA, Yoga for Human Excellence, I met with a major auto rickshaw accident during May 2013. The co-occupant of the vehicle died on the spot since the auto rickshaw bounced and turned that time. My left ankle and ribs were broken. Major surgery was done at Yashoda Hospital, Somajiguda, Hyderabad. I was discharged from the hospital on 5th June 2013. I obtained accelerated recovery in 6 months time and came back to teach yoga classes. The following are my photos showing my position in the hospital bed during June 2013. My prostate gland was affected with cancer and it was removed to avoid spreading the cancer to the other parts of the body by a major surgery. Surgery took 10 hours at Preeti Urology and Kidney Hospital, Hyderabad on 26th January 2016. Open radical prostatectomy with D-obligal ileal done. Post-operatively IVF fluids, IV antibiotics, analgesic antacids given. I was put on SPC Foley's right and left rein. RTA maintained analgesic by epidural infusion with plus 6 ml per hour and central line. Six NBM followed. I was doing well. I completed PhD alternative medicine and obtained the degree during January 2016. I was admitted to G. Kuppuswamy Naidu Memorial Hospital, Coimbatore on 6th June 2016. Rectovesical fistula repair, reconstruction of bladder necks and vesico-urethral anastomosis was done by a major surgery. Surgery took 8 hours on 9th June 2016. I was discharged with stable condition.
My father needs water.
I have the photo of my retrovestular operation on 9th June 2016. Underwent colostomy closure on 3rd November 2016. I came back to normalcy with my yoga activities from 1st January 2017 onwards.
So many complications, sir.
Dr. Chandramohan, Dr. V. Chandramohan, consultant, urologist and surgeon who had performed major operation to me, has given a medical certificate on the first recovery at my advanced age, duly appreciating the phenomenal willpower, yogic therapy and maintaining techniques of yoga used in the first recovery. I will read out the medical certificate given by the doctor. I have never seen a patient like Dr. Sambhasivar Reddy, who at the age of 77 years had such a fast recovery. In fact, the rectovesical fistula is a major complication at any age. Severe catabolism and stress will take away the surgical results even in the young patient. I noticed two things. One, phenomenal willpower, and two, continuous yoga therapy practices with breathing exercises coupled with meditation techniques has helped in the fast recovery of my beloved patient, Mr. K. Sambhasivar Reddy Garu, and very rarely you see such a patient who has not put any pressure on the surgeon during the entire treatment. I thank him for giving a learning opportunity in my academic career. That is the certificate given by the operator doctor. And Dr. Ganesh Gopalakrishnan, professor of urology and consultant urologist who performed a major surgery to me, has examined me and gave a letter commending on my fast remarkable progress. He has given the certificate. I will read out the highlights of the certificate. I am writing this appreciation to Sri Yogacharya Sambhasivar Reddy, who came to see me after he developed a serious complication following surgery for cancer of the prostate. His life must have taken a serious turn, but was stoic and calm and showed no fear or ill effects of the complication. I firmly believe it was his attitude and his immense yogic training that served him at this time. The complication that occurred required another major surgery, which he carried out in Coimbatore. Surgery was major and took nearly 7 hours, but his recovery was quick and did not indicate that he had undergone such major insult to his body. Such again are the powers of yoga, probably. He was discharged from the hospital in 1 week. He preferred to go back to Hyderabad for further recovery. The main problem after such major redo surgery is urine control. It happened to be in Hyderabad at this time and reviewed his progress. At discharge, I had advised him some pelvic floor muscle strengthening exercises. He was able to do these with such consummate ease that it amazed me. He has been able to achieve complete bladder control and has made a remarkable progress from this major surgery. The cancer in his body is under good control, and I am hopeful that he will remain well and pursue his Vedic spiritualization to the fullest, and additionally help many people who seek his guidance. That is the certificate given by the doctor. In spite of my major health setbacks, I regained my lost health and bounced back with the normal health and completed 2 PhDs. One is alternative medicine, that is yogic practices, and another one, yoga philosophy and meditation. And yoga is a great healer. Commendation mail dated 15th August 2016 by 17 by Dr. Ganesh Gopalakrishnan, consultant urologist, after sharing the operation details in urology meeting. I read out the message given by doctor. Dear Mr. Samsureddy, greetings from Coimbatore. I read with great interest your case details. It is amazing that you have recovered so well after all these insults to your body, especially after the RTA. You have shown that yoga is a great healer. I am glad that the hernia is also not an issue. I have recently also shared your case details at our Coimbatore urology meeting. The pictures you have sent on WhatsApp is amazing. Best wishes and regards. That is the certificate given by the doctor. Now, I have successfully used yoga breathing therapy techniques to heal my body when 2 death situations happened in my life. The first one about 8 years back with a terrible auto accident with multiple fractures in my body. The second one was surgery for my prostate cancer, which was terribly went wrong, requiring 4 major operations to get back to normalcy. I sprang back to full strength against all odds by applying yoga breathing therapy techniques, successfully in both the cases and record. During May 2021, I got infected with the Delta variant of COVID-19 and successfully recovered from it. This breathing technique, among other things, includes Nadi Shuddhi Pranayama, which was applied whenever oxygen level drops below 100% while continuously monitoring with pulse oximeter. These techniques simply balances both the hemispheres of the brain and helps to raise the hemoglobin levels by increasing the oxygen carrying capacity in the bloodstream of the body and mind. I have applied the same technique on people who were affected with the COVID-19, producing successful results. I am planning to educate and convince masses about yoga breathing therapy techniques. This technique is simpler, faster, involves no cost. It will help every individual to maintain good health, both physically and mentally. Thank you very much for your time.